The College Station Police Department, with a strength of over 95 employees, proudly serves the city of College Station. College Station, with a population of over 54,000, is the home of Texas A&M University. Texas A&M has an enrollment of 40,000 students and is the major employer and economic force in the community. In 1939, the city appointed its first city marshal. Since that appointment, the College Station Police Department has changed location 6 times to accommodate the increase in officers and staff. The current home of the College Station Police Department houses offices for police administration, the Operations Bureau, and the Services Bureau. The facility has a 9-station weight room and a men's and women's locker room, complete with sauna and showers. Another amenity is a 1/3-mile jogging track that encompasses the department. The men and women who serve the College Station Police Department are proud of these facilities, without question the best in the Brazos Valley, and considered by many to be one of the best in the nation. Approximately twice a year, the department goes through an organized recruiting and hiring process that lasts approximately 6 to 8 weeks. Applicants who successfully complete the process are then hired as either certified or non-certified employees. Certified officers will proceed to a 14-week field training officers program. Non-certified officers are sent through the Basic Law Enforcement Academy at Texas A&M University's Law Enforcement Training Division. Upon successful completion of the course and the state's licensing examination, those officers then proceed to the Field Training Officers Program. The Operations Bureau is the enforcement component of the department. It's made up of 2 divisions. The first such division is Uniform Patrol. These officers normally are assigned to 1 of 3 shifts and usually are the first ones to respond to calls for service. The Uniform Patrol Division is the backbone of the department.
I work so hard to make it every day. Ooh. Ooh.
The Criminal Investigations Division is the other division in the Operations Bureau. Their main responsibility is to perform follow-up investigations on criminal offenses that occur within the city.
Someone stole my brand new Chevrolet, and the rent is due. I've got no place to stay. Ooh. 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 And it's hard to say, 'cause something's never changed, and it's hard to find in a strength to talk.
Units that operate under the control of the Operations Bureau are the communications section. These individuals have the responsibilities of answering incoming calls, dispatching units to calls, and jailing. The traffic section consists of 3 officers working primarily on motorcycles. Their main function is traffic control and accident prevention and reduction. The Special Operations Response Team is a group of officers who are trained to handle such critical incidents as hostage situations, barricaded subjects, high-risk felony arrests, and search and rescue. The Hostage Negotiations Team is trained and equipped to respond to critical incidents involving barricaded subjects, hostage situations, or other situations where negotiations with a subject may help bring the situation to a peaceful conclusion. Department's Color Guard participates in formal departmental ceremonies such as awards, funerals, and parades. The Color Guard also represents the department in the Police Officer Memorial Services held in May of each year. The Special Services Division consists of two sections. The Crime Prevention and Community Relations section teaches the Drug Abuse Resistance Education, or DARE, program to all fifth graders. A new program called Tigers, Teens in Grade Ending Reliance on Substances, was implemented in the high school during the 1988-89 school year. This section is also responsible for the formation and maintenance of neighborhood watch groups.
Just no time to stop and get away. 'Cause I work so hard to make it every day.
The recruiting and training section does proactive recruiting, searching for qualified applicants for the department. It's also responsible for the training of the department's personnel. Officers receive on the average of 8 hours of in-service each month. This section identifies training needs and develops training programs. One such program is the Emergency Vehicle Operations Course. This course tests the officer's ability to handle a vehicle at high speeds and while driving under stress. A great deal of time and money is invested to ensure that this department hires the most qualified personnel available. The department actively seeks and encourages applications from both minorities and women. If qualified, you too may have the opportunity to become a member of a proven progressive law enforcement agency, the College Station Police Department.
The heat is on.
Terminated. All subjects in custody.